गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन टीचिंग सेशन ऑफ एकेडमिक वर्ल्ड स्कूल बेमेतरा। टुडे वी आर हियर विद द सक्सेडिंग टॉपिक ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज एंड फील्ड, एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल। इन आवर प्रीवियस videos, we have studied the electric field due to a single charge, and we have also seen the electric field due to a system of charge if there are many charges. Okay, so now today we will see the electric dipoles and the electric field due to it. The question in your mind must be, what is this electric dipole? Sure, so I will explain you. Dipole, electric dipole, as the name says, there will be two charges. So when two charges, say minus Q and plus Q, in a dipole there will be two charge of equal magnitude and opposite sign. They are kept at a distance between them. Let us say from the center the distance is A and A, so total distance 2A. So the electric dipole is two charges of equal and opposite magnitudes are kept at distance from each other. That is called a electric dipole. What is electric dipole? Equal and opposite charge which are separated by a finite distance that is called electric dipole, is called an electric dipole. Okay, plus minus Q, plus Q. So when we study any dipole, we need to measure its properties. So in the dipole, if you will see technically, it has equal and opposite charge, and if you add the charge, it will be zero. Plus Q, minus Q, the total is zero. So dipole is electrically neutral. But what will be the measure? We measure dipole moment. There is a property called dipole moment. Every dipole will have its characteristic dipole moment that we will measure. So how to measure dipole moment? Dipole moment. Dipole moment is a property of this any electric dipole, and it is equal to the product of either of the charge. See, there are two charge, minus Q and plus Q. So you have to take the magnitude of either of the charge, that is Q. Product of either of the charge magnitude with the distance between it. Okay, so if suppose the distance is 2a and the charge is magnitude is Q, so dipole moment will be Q multiplied by 2a. This is your dipole moment. Okay, so dipole moment, it is a vector. Vector, when we say, it means it has a direction. So the direction of the magnet, this dipole moment is from negative to
positive, this side. So dipole moment P is a vector along the direction of this P, the positive side, and it is product of the distance and the charge. I hope it is clear. Once again, dipole means two charges equal and opposite in magnitude. When they are separated by a small distance, then they are said to be an electric dipole, or they make a electric dipole. What is the property? Property is the dipole moment. Product of the any of the charge Q with the distance. So what is the distance here? 2a. 2a multiplied by charge is equal to dipole moment. I will write once again. So dipole moment is charge magnitude of charge multiplied by distance, that is say Q into 2a. This is,
what is the direction? The direction is always towards from negative to positive side. Okay, so the direction will be from negative to positive. Do we have the dipoles in nature? Yes, there are many dipoles which we can find in nature. Let me give you one example. Hydrochloric acid molecule, HCl molecule.
The molecule of HCl, it is an example of dipole in nature. Dipole in nature.
Nature means natural. Okay, artificially you can make any dipole. You can charge two objects opposite and separate them. But natural dipoles, if you want to know, a molecule of HCl, you know, hydrogen is slightly positive charge and chlorine is slightly negative charge, and there is a distance, bond length. Okay, so the atom of HCl is a natural electric dipole. There are some more, like as H2O. H2O molecule is like this. Okay, so there is a slight positive charge on this side and a negative charge on the opposite side. These negative and positives are equal in magnitude and there is a small distance between them. So we can say the molecule of HCl and water, H2O, are the natural dipoles. There are some more natural molecules which are natural dipole. Okay, you can find out from your own books. Okay, ideal dipole. Whenever we study something, the final our interest is what is the ideal one. Ideal. Okay, so ideally the dipole must be having an infinite charge separated by a small distance. Okay, so ideal dipole, write down, ideal dipole. The ideal dipole consists of a large charge separated by a small distance. Ideal dipole. An ideal dipole has infinite charge. Infinite charge, and the distance must be zero. Actually, all the ideal things are never possible, like things. So we are only having an imagination of an ideal dipole. An ideal dipole must have a large charge, one positive and one negative, two large charges of equal and opposite magnitude, and their separation of distance must be very very small. So practically you cannot have any ideal dipole because large charges will definitely attract each other. Okay, what is the most ideal dipole we can have in nature is any molecule. You know, molecular lengths are very small. So any molecular natural molecule which is in dipole, that you can assume to be ideal dipole. Okay.
So dipoles we have studied.
So whenever we study any charge or a combination of charge such as dipole, the question is there in our mind, what is the electric field? And we have studied the electric field due to one charge and due to many charge. So here also our next area of interest is electric field due to a dipole. Electric field due to dipole. Okay, so any dipole, if you will see, it has got two equal and opposite charge, plus q and minus q, which are separated by a small distance. So if the charge is cancelled by each other, then there should be no electric field, because if charge is zero, there should be no electric field. Whereas it doesn't happen. So the reason is there is some finite distance between the two charges, and at the same point both of these charges are going to have different influence. Okay, so at this point there will be one electric field by the positive charge and one electric field due to the negative charge. Both of these electric fields are together going to have an impact on this point, and that's why there will be definitely one electric field, positive finite electric field. Let us see what is the electric field and how does it vary. So about the variation, I can say if the distance between the point and the dipole, okay, now see here, this is suppose a dipole which has dipole moment P and the distance between them is 2a. Okay, if the point lies somewhere where R and A are comparable, then the electric field is proportional to 1 upon r square. It will decay as you go away from the dipole, the distance, okay, it will fade away. Electric field from the dipole is related like this. R is the distance of the point where you are considering the electric field. So if r increases, with the square power of r, the electric field fades. But if the distance is very very large as compared to this distance A, if the distance is very very large, say the dipole is just 1 centimeter and you are considering the point at 5 meter, which is 5000 times. So in that case, 500 times. So in that case, electric field will fade by power of 1 upon R cube. Okay, so here the electric field fades away more drastically. So therefore, the electric field at far away points is very less and it fits. But up to some extent there is. So we will first study the dipole.
Okay. Electric field due to dipole. Okay. If this is a dipole,
I will draw it here.
Another. If this is a dipole minus Q and plus Q, okay, then there are two possibilities. First is the point may lie here. This is the point. This is called axial line. This is two charge minus Q and plus Q, and the line along the line joining the two charges, that line is called axial line. So on the axial line there is a point you have chosen, and this point there will be electric field due to both of these charges.
Okay, so first you write the heading.
The heading is electric field due to an electric dipole at axial point, at an axial point.
Electric field due to dipole at an axial point.
Here point is P. Now what are the other things? The center of the dipole is here. So this is your A, this is also A. A plus A, 2A. The distance of the point P from the dipole is R. Okay, so distance of the point from the center of the dipole is R. So what will be the distance of point P from plus Q? It will be R minus A. And what is the distance of point P from minus Q? It will be R plus A.
Okay.
The electric field produced by the two charges can be calculated separately. I am writing it E minus Q. E minus Q says electric field due to the charge minus Q. It will be equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus Q upon distance square. Okay. Similarly, this plus Q will also have one electric field here. So what will be these two electric fields? First of all, this minus Q, I will take positive test charge. So plus positive and negative charge will attract, and therefore the direction of the electric field is E minus Q on this side, which you will say along negative side of P. P is this vector. Okay. So along the negative side of P. Okay. So now electric field due to the plus Q, it will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q upon R minus A whole square. Here the distance between Q naught and plus Q, Q naught and plus Q is R minus A. Okay. So the direction of this plus Q is towards this side. One is along the negative P and another one towards positive P. If I take this as O, so OP here it is along positive P.
another one acting on the positive side. So what will be the effective electric field? The effective electric field E is equal to sum of these two, E minus Q plus E plus Q. Electric field due to the negative and positive. Here I will like to represent the direction vector P cap. P cap is the direction vector along the P vector. This is your P vector from minus to Q. Okay. So now let us write down electric field E is equal to sum of these two. I will write down 1 upon 4 pi epsilon minus Q R plus A square plus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon plus Q R minus A square. Both are having the common vector direction, that is P cap. Minus, okay. So this minus sign I will introduce. Common things are Q and 1 upon 4 pi epsilon, and it is 1 upon, this is positive, R minus A whole square minus 1 upon R plus A whole square. See, this was negative minus Q, so I have taken it minus this 1 upon R minus A square. Okay, this positive thing I have taken here. Now, this is R minus A square. R minus A square means R minus A into R minus A. Okay, and here it is R plus A into R plus A. So, by using the relation A minus B into A plus B is equal to A square minus B square. This relation I will use. So, it will be Q upon 4 pi epsilon. It will be R square minus A square, and again R square minus A square, and this side R plus A whole square minus R minus A whole square. Now when I solve R plus A square, what is R plus A square? That is A plus B square. It will be A square plus B square plus 2AB. Similarly, A minus B square is equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB. So what are the AB? AB are R and A. Okay. So here it will be Q upon 4 pi epsilon, it will be 4 AR upon R square minus A square whole square into P cap. Okay. So, electric field is Q upon 4 pi epsilon 4 AR. Now, we know that 2A into Q is P. 2A into Q is P. So I will substitute here. This E equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon. Then here it is Q into 4AR. So Q into 2 into 2A into R. This 4A I have deliberately changed into 2 into 2A. Okay. 2 into 2 is 4. So 2 into 2 into A into R. Now this 2A and Q, these two product means P. Upon what is the denominator? R square minus A square whole square
p cap. Okay. So now these two I will replace 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p vector r vector upon r square minus a square whole square. P cap is a direction unit vector. See, unit vectors, they have only one rule, they tell the direction. Here it is along the p. Is there a negative sign here? No, it's a positive sign. So this will be the count of the magnitude and the direction. So what is this electric field we were studying at axial point? Okay, so electric field at axial point is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 2 p r upon r square minus a square whole square p. This is when r and a are comparable. What are r and a? R is the distance of the test charge from the center of the dipole. But if the dipole is very small size and the distance is very very large, in that case what will happen? In that case r square minus a square, see, a square will be negligible, you can just neglect it. So in that case e axial becomes 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 2 p r upon r square minus 0 k square, that will be r to the power 4. Okay, so r and 1 r cancel, this becomes 2 p by r cube. So this shows that at axial point the electric field due to a dipole will be proportional to 1 upon r cube. E is proportional to 1 upon r cube. Okay, so let me summarize it once again. Here the electric field will be because of the both the charges minus q and plus q. So one is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon minus q upon r plus a square, and plus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon q upon r minus a square. Okay, joining both of them we get e axial is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 2 p upon r cube into p cap. P cap is the unit vector, and we have seen e is proportional to 1 upon r cube. Next we will see if this point axial, this point of test charge is not on the axial line but it is on the equatorial line. Let us see that also. So here are the test charges. And this is your point P. This is A, B, P, this is O. Now the electric field due to minus q will be along this side, and the electric field due to plus q will be along this side. Okay. Here is the test charge q naught. There will be two components of them
consider that there are two charges minus q plus q and there is a point p. The distance of the point p is r from the center o. Okay, op is equal to r. So here this distance is r square plus a square according to the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, similarly here also it is r square plus a square root. Okay. First we will find electric field at P due to minus Q. It is E minus Q. It will be along PA. Okay. And the value will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon minus Q R square plus A square. Okay. And this direction is along PA. Along PA. This is electric field due to minus Q. And there will be electric field due to plus Q. So the electric field due to plus Q charge will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q upon R square plus A square and it will be along BP forward. Okay, this is your electric field along plus Q. Since I have calculated the magnitude, this negative sign I can omit because I am giving the direction. Direction is along this side. Okay. Now this, you consider this diagram here. In this diagram, okay, these are the two vectors and this is the diagonal of this parallelogram. Okay. So, according to the law of addition of vectors, I will consider this is the resultant vector electric field. See, the electric field, this E plus Q will have two components. One is along the vertical side and one is along the parallel side of this AB. So, if there is a vertical side electric field this side, nah, it is your, if this is your theta angle, here also it will be theta, this is theta, okay. So this is your E sine theta. E sine theta due to this plus Q and there will be E sine theta due to this one, both of them E sine theta, I will magnify only this area now. See here. This is E plus Q and this is E minus Q and the resultant vectors, these are the perpendicular components. Okay. And here is angle theta. So E sine theta due to plus Q and E sine theta on the downward side due to minus Q, they are going to cancel each other. What will be left will be only this much. So the component along the
AB direction is called E cos theta. E cos theta because of plus Q and E cos theta due to minus Q. Okay, so net electric field due to the due to both the charges will be E is equal to E cos theta plus E cos theta. Two times, that is 2E cos theta. Now what is this E cos theta? We have already calculated E. The value of E is same for plus Q and minus Q, only direction is different. Now this plus Q is acting along BP and electric field due to minus Q is acting along PA. They are equal in magnitude but different in direction, and their sign components are cancelling. What is left? Only cos component. And we have seen both the cos components are acting in the same direction. So E cos theta plus E cos theta, both cos component of both the electric field we will add. Okay, so let us calculate what is this cos component sum total. E equals to E cos theta plus E cos theta equals to 2E cos theta. Okay, now this is 2 electric field, it is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q upon R square plus A square into cos theta. Let us see in this triangle, if this is theta, what is cos theta? Cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. Base is A and hypotenuse is R square plus A square. So it is A upon R square plus A square root. Substitute the value here. So electric field is 2 into 1 upon 4 pi epsilon into Q upon R square plus A square multiplied by, now recently we have found the value of cos theta. Cos theta stands A upon root R square plus A square. R square plus A square again into root of R square plus A square. This is to the power of 3 upon 2. So now there is one more substitution. 2 Q and A, what I told you, 2 Q A is dipole moment. We have seen dipole moment P is equal to Q into 2A, and all the three things are here, just multiply them. So here and it will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon P upon R square plus A square to the power of 3 by 2. Okay, so again we see here the direction is on the negative side. What is the direction here? It is on the negative side. So we will put that factor P cap minus. I told you P cap is not having any magnitude. It is implied only for the purpose of direction. So it will be minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon P upon R square plus a square to the power of 3 3 by 2.
Now again, if this size of dipole is very very small, r is much smaller, r is much greater than a, in that case I can neglect a square. So what will be, it will be in that case when r is much bigger than a, then a square is neglected. So it will be E equatorial point is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon P divided by R square to the power 3 by 2, that is R cube, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon P upon R cube. So here also we see E is proportional to 1 upon R cube. One thing you have to note, that in the equatorial line the direction is towards the negative P. Okay, then what else? Here earlier it was 2P in the axial and it is single P. So we can say E axial is 2 times of E equatorial if R is same. At same R, the value of equatorial and axial electric field, that is the ratio, axial electric field will be twice of equatorial electric field. Okay. So today we have understood that the dipoles, what are dipoles? Two equal and opposite charges at some distance from each other. How there are natural dipoles and what is the nature of their intensity of electric field at axial point and equatorial point. In the next class we are going to see the torque acting on the electric dipole. I hope you all will study and complete the assignments. Assignments are very important. Please do them as soon as possible and submit me on the ERP. Happy learning and have a healthy and safe stay at home. Thank you.